And new numbers tonight from the Florida Education Association show teachers statewide are not comfortable with returning to the classroom. ABC 27's Christian Thomas breaks down those numbers and talks to educators about their fight to keep themselves and their students safe.
I'm terrified to go back to school.
Chris Guerrieri is a teacher in Jacksonville, a COVID-19 hotspot in the state. He is also one of thousands of teachers across Florida who say they aren't being heard.
We're yelling at the top of our lungs, keep us safe, protect our families. But unfortunately, a lot of people just aren't listening.
The Florida Education Association, who recently filed a lawsuit against the state, released results of a survey from teachers and parents all over Florida. They found
among teachers and staff in our schools, 73% said they did not want to return at this point in time.
53% of parents are not comfortable sending their children back to brick-and-mortar schools, while others are unsure. Denise Deanna is a parent and teacher in Bradenton and says,
it's very clear, okay? COVID is dangerous. It is here. It is killing people, and it is killing children. Children are spreading it. And we need to deal with it in a very systematic way.
That's why both Denise and Chris took the FEA survey and have also signed a petition to keep school buildings closed for the school year. The petition started by Dave Finnegan in Osceola County, getting almost 100,000 signatures. They say since no one is listening, they need to do everything they can to keep people safe.
We need to step up as a state, and we need to get the community spread down. And until it gets down, we need to help those people who can't teach their...
Their only hope is that the state will listen.
I want to be there. I miss my kids. I miss going to work. But if we can't do it safely, if we can't keep children safe, families safe, and teachers safe, then what is the point?
In Tallahassee, Christian Thomas, ABC 27.
The FEA received more than 50,000 responses to that survey. They say they want school to start, but think online learning might be the best option.